Hello everyone, so welcome back to this channel once again, and in this video session I'll discuss work spool file from ACS, that is access client solution in IBM AS400. So we know that we can use the WRKSPLF command from the IBM green screen, and we can access to the spool files generated on the IBM machine. So by default it will open the current user spool file. You can have various parameters here which you can specify to display even all users, or with the user data, form type, other things, or to the particular job name, particular user if you want. So this thing you can do from here using the WRKSPLF command, that is on the IBM green screen. But let me show you if the same thing you can perform from the ACS. So let me open the access client solution first. So it's opening, let's wait. It has been opened, so you can see the first thing is you must have a system setup here. And then you need to go to the printer output option there. You click, and then we will provide the user ID and password to log in. So once you log in, you will see the default spool file, that is for the current user, which is set. And you can see you can delete this. So these are the list of spool files which have been loaded here, and that's the same thing you can see from here as well. And so now let's see what options you can, or what things you can, what actions you can do from here. So once you right click on any spool file, you can download that, you can hold that, you can delete that, you can delete that, you can move that. So let me show you how we can download this. Let's click on download. You can download to desktop, to temporary location, product configuration root here, or specify location. Let me specify location and then browse that. So I can download it anywhere on system. Let me download it on the desktop. Just open, append system name, yes, and use the PDF format if applicable. I can select it or not. Let's select this and click on OK. So this will start downloading that QP job log spool file. And once it is downloaded, you can see it here that 27 KB has been downloaded. Let me show you here. So this has been downloaded, and once you open this, you will see the job log. So this is the job log which has been downloaded from the printer output screen on the ACS. So the most important thing which I showed you with the WRKSPLF command, the same thing you can do here. Let's on edit, you can select set filter. Now here you can see what are all parameters which were there on the work link. You can specify here by setting the filter. You can specify all user, or you can specify a user. You can specify an output queue. You can specify even the job information. If you want to, you can specify the user data. You can see the user data, or if some spools have user data, some do not have. Let's select new user data. Once you select that, it will reload that list, and you'll see the spool so reloaded with no user data. Let me set the filter, specify some user data. So I specified SQL here. So only those spool files open which have the user data SQL. So this way you can specify the date, specification time as well. Let me select this so you can specify this as well. So even you can reset all those things. So click on this reset everything, click on OK, and then you'll again open the default. So this way, using the printer output on the ACS, you can download the spool files, or you can set the filter to load the list of spool files which you want to see. So that's all in this video. Thank you.